Hi, this is David with HR Technical Support. Today we're going to be covering our Micref 320 SS, which is our fridge, freezer, and microwave combo dorm unit. This consists of our CRF 320 fridge freezer and an Avanti 0.7 cubic foot microwave. All right, here we have our CRF 320 SS. This is our dorm size fridge, and what we're going to be covering today is a setup for a dorm room with a fridge and microwave combination. So I'm going to talk a little bit about each one, and then we'll show you how it all goes together. So on this one, we have a stainless steel front. When you unpack it out of the box, we're going to have some blue film. And if you look, there's a little bit of residue here. This has been removed, but this is a really nice piece of stainless here. And speaking of stainless, inside here on the freezer, this is a true 0 degree freezer. And I'm going to open this up so you can see the inside of that. And again, we don't have any temperature control up here. This is zero all the time. We've got plenty of room up here for TV dinners and other frozen items. And here you have a retaining bar on the shelf, and you could put some more inside the door. Down below, we have our fridge. Now, our fridge gets down into the low 30s, so it's ideal for storing most foods. And we have some features here, some accessories that come with it. We have a crisper drawer. Glass shelving, you have a light, and there's your light switch. And your temperature control is right here. We have a soda can rack or beer can rack if you're so inclined. We have space here for a little half gallon of milk, and space for eggs up here as well. Now, the freezer is not auto defrost. It has to be manually defrosted, which means you're going to turn the unit off, put some towels in it, and let it melt and soak that water up and get it out of there. The freezer is, again, is not self-defrosting, but the fridge is. So you really won't need to do much with this. The fridge part will take care of itself. And again, the fridge goes down to the low 30s, and we're at absolute true zero up here. So with that being said, those are some of the features on the unit, and we're going to talk about our microwave that goes on top of the unit next. Okay, and here we have our Avanti microwave unit that we're going to be using on top of the combo. This is not our unit. This is not manufactured by EdgeStar. This is an Avanti unit. We've decided to use this unit here in our combo. And this unit's pretty small. It's 0.7 cubic foot. It does have a turntable in here as well for even cooking. Of course, we have our cabinet light. And as far as the features on the unit, they're pretty well standard for any low-budget microwave. Most of the college kids, they eat pizza and baked potatoes and things like that. Frozen banquet dinners and lots of ramen. So you have your standard fare here, your keypad, and then you have some pre-programmed settings for different types of foods. Again, pizza, baked potatoes, things like that. This is a fairly low-powered unit. It's 700 watts. So if you're used to a 1200-watt microwave, this one's going to take about 50% longer to cook foods than a 1200 microwave will. So, and again, the reason we did that was specific because, again, we have to stay under that 10-amp draw mark, so this is going to help us do that. And, of course, we have ventilation on the sides here. Speaking of ventilation, and I didn't cover that earlier, but I want to talk about that real quick. This entire combo unit is not meant to be built in any way. It needs to be freestanding, especially the microwave, because we have sensitive components in here that we need to have cooled off. So we have our intake back here in the back of the unit and our exhaust here on the side. And the fridge is actually not front vented, so we're not going to be able to build that in either. So again, they need to be freestanding somewhere in the dorm room. We've got a couple of other accessories we're going to cover as well for this unit to put it all together. We'll talk about that in our next segment. Okay, here in front of us we have the Avanti electrical switch box for our combo unit. Now, bear in mind that the combo unit does not come with this switching box, and this is what keeps us under 10 amps. This is considered an accessory, and it's an extra purchase from our retailer, Compact Appliance, and this is model number AC3. This is not, also again, not made by EdgeStar. This is manufactured by Avanti. They sell it as an accessory. Again, the combo unit does not come with this switch box. What this switch box does is it will alternate power between the fridge freezer combo and the microwave. So, for example, if we're running the microwave, in order to keep the total power draw under 10 amps, we're going to run the microwave, but we're going to cut off the fridge. Same goes in reverse. If we're running the fridge and we're trying to use the microwave isn't going to work because the fridge is going to take priority. Now, you'll notice there's three plugs here. We have a spare outlet. If you need to run something else, you can do that, but bear in mind that whatever you plug into that outlet is going to be switched the same as the fridge and the microwave combo. So if you're plugging a clock radio or something in there, be advised that that radio is going to cut off. You're going to lose your time on it because it's switched just like the rest of these. Primarily though, the fridge is our main unit, and that's the one that takes priority. So again, if the fridge is running, the microwave and your other outlet aren't going to work. So there's really nothing to this box. We have three grounded outlets here. They're physically marked as to which one, both here in front of the plug, which you can't see really well, and here on the label on the top. So microwave, fridge, and then your other, what they call other, your spare outlet. And in the back of this is just your standard three-prong grounded plug. And as you can see here, it's not unlike anything else. But this is what keeps it under 10 amps because we're only running one item at a time. So you really do need to have this when you buy the combo because the dormitory is not going to supply anything but the wall outlet. And if you plug everything into the wall outlets, well, they're going to run all the time. And that's what they don't want. So you need to have this box as accessory to complete your purchase. All right, so here we have the back of our unit. We're ready to install our bracket. Now, your bracket comes in a little box, and it's got some extra parts that we're not going to be using. Matter of fact, namely, it's these black brackets right here. So we're not going to be using those. We're going to set those aside. Those go with a different model. This is part of a multi-fit kit. Really, the only thing that you're going to need here are the three silver screws that come in a little baggie, and then the bracket itself. I'll show you how that goes on in a minute. There's a couple of things that you're going to need tool-wise to do this, and yes, you're going to have to drill some holes. So in order to do this, what you need is a 3/32 drill bit, just like that. Now I use one with a hex end here because of the way my drill is set up, but you can use a regular bit, it's nothing special. You have a number two a screwdriver bit here, it's a Phillips. And this is one that you might not normally have. This is called a tamper-proof Torx socket, and basically what it is there's a hole in the center of this socket, and on the back of the microwave, there's two screws that you have to take out. They're what we call tamper-proof. And that center of that hole fits, there's a stud that sticks out of the screw, and that hole fits the stud so that you can get the bit down in there and get the screw out. This is a specialty bit. I got this at my local hardware store. It's a T20, and it's a security bit. It needs to have a hole here in the center of the bit. If you get a regular T20 Torx, it's not going to work because it's not going to be able to go down in there past that stud and get into those corners so that we can grab the screw. So it's got to be a tamper-proof one. So what we're going to do here is the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take the two screws out of the back of the microwave because eventually we're going to have to do that anyway. Now I'm using a power driver here. You can use whatever you want. So we're going to take that security bit. We're going to take out these two lower cabinet screws. All right. Now what we're going to do is we're going to switch bits here. We're going to go to our drill bit. And the first thing that you're going to do is you're going to line this bracket up on the back of the microwave. Now, the way this works is that this bracket will roughly line up with this screw here on the back of the fridge unit and this one here, and then it lines up with this here and this hole over here, the ones that I just took out. Now, you're not going to use these, just use them as a point of reference. So you're going to square everything up and make sure everything is straight. And once it is, then you're going to go in here and you're going to mark your holes with a bit of paint or a highlighter or whatever you have. White out, doesn't really matter. You're going to mark on the back of the fridge here where your holes are going to be. So you want to make sure that this is all lined up and perpendicular here and here. And you're going to want to back the microwave up, which I've already done, and I've double checked it, and everything lines up. So you're going to push the microwave back, make sure everything lines up, push the microwave forward, and now you can come in here and pull the bracket and then drill your holes. So I've already pre-drilled my holes, and I've got four of them here. So you're just going to get it started with the drill bit and drill each one. There's four of them. Once you're done with that, you're going to set your bracket back in place. And by the way, when you're drilling into this, you don't need to go the full length of the bit. I would probably go about there, which is about a quarter, just under half. When you feel the plastic give and you get into the foam, you can back it out and stop. You don't need to run it all the way down. And mainly because the screws that you're going to be using to attach the bracket are really short, so you don't need a lot of hole there. So what we're going to do now, so I'm going to get my screws up that hold my bracket down, because I've already drilled my holes. And I'm going to put my Phillips bit back in. And then I'm going to put my screws in the holes that I've drilled. Now remember, and I wanted to show you this, these half moon shapes here and here fit the legs on the microwave, the ones that fits the bottom one. So you need to put it in with those half moon pieces facing that way towards the front of the fridge. So it's going to go just like this. And you're going to set that down, and then you can start your holes. So I'm just going to stick my screws in the holes. Get a couple of threads started here. I like to start them by hand. It's just easier to work with them that way. And then we'll get this last screw in there. Then we can go ahead and run them down. Now when you run these in there, don't over tighten it because you're making your own threads. It's just plastic. If you strip it out, you're done. So when you tighten these down, just tighten them down enough to where they stop turning. Or you could set, if you have an adjustable clutch on your drill like I do, you could set it really low so that the clutch will cut out once it hits. Just make sure you don't drive them down with a bunch of torque, because that's the easiest way to strip these out. Because again, we're just going into plastic here. Once my drill slows down, I stop turning. All right, so our little bracket's secure now. So what we're gonna do, is we're gonna push our microwave back. Let me get this. And remember, you've still got these two tamper-proof bits, these screws, and these screws have little star washers. Make sure you don't lose them, because now we're gonna slide the microwave back, we're gonna put our screws in, and we're done. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna use our specialty bit again. The one I showed you earlier, that Torx, we're going to use that to put these screws back in. So I'm ready to go ahead and move this microwave back. So we're going to move the microwave back. And get it to where we lined up. I'm going to go ahead and change bits here. And we'll go ahead and run the other one in. Might want to drape the cord if the cord gets in the way like this one did. Just stick it in front of the handle up here. Go ahead and get this one started. And then we can go ahead and run that last tamper-proof screw in. And look at that, you're all done. That's how it goes together. All right, so I wanted to give you an overview again of the back of the unit, and we're going to talk a little bit about the switch box, the switching outlet that we use to keep this total draw of both of these units under 10 amps. So it's important that once you get that bracket installed and you're all set, the last thing you're going to do is plug in your switching box. Now remember, you have a specific slot for the microwave, specific one for the fridge, and then you have a spare if you want to use it. And that spare is not hot all the time. It is switched. So what you're going to do is plug your microwave and fridge in, and you're going to plug this end of it into the wall. And this is a standard grounded outlet, by the way. What's going to happen is that the fridge is going to always be primary. It has to be, because we got to keep our food cold. Now, if you decide to use the microwave, it's going to switch that primary from the fridge to the microwave. And then you can use the microwave, and it will cut the fridge off during the time that the microwave is in use. Once you've stopped using the microwave and you hit that stop button and you reset the microwave, the power will then switch back to the fridge. Bear in mind that it's also going to switch that other outlet, the spare one here. It's going to switch that one along with the fridge or the microwave, depending on which one you're using at any given time. So if you're plugging something else into that other slot, it's marked other, make sure that whatever it isn't critical to you that it has a clock or timer on it, because you're never going to be able to keep a constant time on it. Every time it switches, you're going to lose the juice. So make sure that whatever you're putting in there is something you're actually not worried about losing power to if you're using one device or the other. And again, this keeps our amp draw below 10 amps. This is what they want on those circuits, because the circuits in those college dorm rooms are overloaded as it is. This will help to really keep that amperage draw down. I hope that this do-it-yourself video has helped you to set up and run your new MicRef 320 SS combo. If you have any questions or concerns, please contact EdStar at www.edstar.com.